It is now 6:30. Let me call the January 24th, 2017 school board meeting to order. Termination, we have a quorum. Dr. Norberto Cantu.
Present.
Mr. Eduardo Ramirez.
Present.
Ms. Judith Solis. Dr. B.
Present.
Mr. Eliasal Velazquez.
Present.
Myself, Daniel Garcia, is present as well. We do have a quorum. I believe the Pledge of Allegiance, Dr. Trevino, I know we have a lot of kids. I hate to put one in the spot. I don't know if anyone would want to volunteer to lead us on the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Section 3, approval of minutes for the regular board meeting for December 15, 2016. Do we have a motion?
So move, Mr. President.
We have a motion by Mr. Ramirez. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Dr. Cantu. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign, motion carries. Section 4, public forum. Item 1, School Board Recognition Month, January 26, 17, theme, All-Star Team, reading of the proclamation and presentation by RGCCISD students.
Before we begin our presentation by our students, we would like to make a brief announcement. We will be having our two mariachis performing their state competition music. We are requesting that there will be no video or audio taping of their performances. There will be no audio or videotaping of the performances. Thank you. We will now begin with our presentation.
Good evening, Mr. Daniel Garcia, School Board President, Board Members, Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Alfredo Garcia, and to all attending this special recognition of our school board members. At this time, we will begin with a special presentation by our very own 4-8 state champions, Gruya High School Mariachi Gruya de Plata. Our mariachi will be performing their 2017 state competition show in your honor. Sit back and enjoy.
This month of January provides a unique opportunity to acknowledge a special group of elected officials in education. They are called school board members. They take responsibility and public trust very seriously, dedicating an enormous number of hours to their work, both in and outside of board meetings. School board members are guardians of the public trust, and through the policies they make, are ultimately responsible for the success of local public education.
Often, we take for granted the service that these education advocates provide. Taking time to say thank you is the least we can do, as they provide vision and leadership for student achievement. They are frontline advocates serving every child every day. January is School Board Recognition Month, and Rio Grande City CISD would like to thank these local leaders for their dedication and willingness to serve as our advocates. We will continue with our presentation with the reading of the proclamation by Dr. Arcadio J. Salinas III, Assistant Superintendent for Human Resources and Professional Accountability.
Thank you. Mr. Board President, members of the board, Mr. Garcia, Superintendent of Schools, students and staff, all committee members present, I have the honor to read tonight's proclamation. Whereas the mission of the public schools is to meet the diverse educational needs of all children, to empower them to become competent, productive contributors to democratic society and an ever-changing world. And whereas local school board members are committed to children and believe that all children can be successful learners and the best education is tailored to the individual needs of a child. And whereas local school board members work closely with parents, educational professionals, and other community members to create the educational vision that we want for our students. And whereas local school board members are responsible for ensuring the structure that provides a solid foundation for our school system. And whereas local school board members are strong advocates for public education, are responsible for communicating the needs of the school district to the public, and the public's expectations to the district. Now, therefore, I, Arcadio J. Salinas III, do hereby declare my appreciation to the members of the Rio Grande City CISD School Board and proclaim the month of January 2017 as School Board Recognition Month in Rio Grande City, Texas. I urge all citizens to join me in recognizing the dedication and hard work of local school board members and working with them to mold an education system that meets the needs of both today's and tomorrow's children. In official recognition whereof, I hereby affix my signature the 24th day of January 2017. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Salinas. At this time, our superintendent of schools, Mr. Alfredo Garcia, will present our school board members with their certificate of appreciation, which reads, for dedicated leaderships in public education and continuing services to the children of this community. Please come forward when your name is called.
Before I present the plaques to our board members, I'd like to say that on behalf of our community, the school, the Rio Grande City School District, and our students, we want to thank each and every one of you, Dr. Cantu, Mr. Ramirez, Mr. Garcia, Ms. Solis, Dr. B, Mr. Eliazar. Thank you all very much for your commitment. It is a pleasure for me itself to be your superintendent and to work here with such a dedicated group of board members. I'm honored to be here with you all and to continue working for the betterment of our district and to continue setting the foundation for our students. Once again, on behalf of all of us, thank you so much. Mr. Danny Garcia.
Mr. Eduardo Ramirez. Ms. Judith A. Solis. Dr. Daria Babino. Dr. Norberto Cantu, Jr. We're sad to announce that Ms. Letio Lopez wasn't able to make it today, but she's still our board member. Mr. Eliezer Velasquez Jr. Thank you very much, Mr. Garcia. The theme for this year's school board, the theme for this year's School Board Appreciation Month is All-Star Team. By definition, an all-star team is composed of winners made up of top performers who are most skilled and accomplished.
Whether you are a New York Yankees fan or a hail from Red Sox Nation, whether you are a diehard Green Bay Packer or a Dallas Cowboys fan, whether you root for the Kentucky Wildcats, Louisville Cardinals, UCLA Bruins, or Kansas Jayhawks.
Boy, do we have a team for you. A team for the ages, RGCCISD, all-time, all-star team.
This all-star team show us that passion,
a great amount of discipline,
a whole lot of courage,
and tons of imagination score more than home runs, touchdowns, or points. They are the state's hardest hitting defenders of students.
Just as it's one thing to be in a team, it's quite another to perform as a team member. Tom Brady, Deion Sanders, LeBron James, Brian Ruth, Serena Williams, Nolan Ryan. One mention of any of those names can bring out visions of greatness, determination, and winning.
However, one vision outweighs all others, the RGCCISD team members. Each of these board members was assigned an adjective that best describes them as an all-star.
Mr. Daniel Garcia, you are easily distinguished for your excellence.
Ms. Judith Amanda Solis, you have honored your promise to ensure students come first.
Mr. Eduardo Ramirez, you have produced remarkable results in making this team successful.
Dr. Norberto Cantu, your positive attitude and eagerness are your most notable features.
Ms. Leti Lopez, you are an excellent role model to all.
Mr. Eliezer Velasquez, your glorious personality shines and follows you wherever you go.
Dr. Babineau, you are well known for your unselfish services to this community.
Your outstanding sportsmanship and your dynamic personalities make up the most invincible team ever assembled. Oh, by the way, these will be the most valuable sought-out cards ever.
Thank you, students, for giving the audience a courtside seat as we pay tribute to our school board members. Great job.
Y'all be nice and jolly.
Next, we have our very own 5A state champions, Rio Grande City High School Mariachi Cascabel. They will be performing their 2017 state competition show. Mariachi state finals will be on Saturday, February 4, 2017 at South San Antonio High School. Good luck to both mariachi groups and keep up the tradition of excellence. We thank you, our school board members, for being our 2017 lineup, our most valuable All-Star team ever. We will conclude this ceremony by inviting everyone to enjoy the refreshments. Have a great evening.
Well, first of all, on behalf of the board, to everybody here and all the parents who brought the kids, thank you so much. You all really made our day. And of course, the mariachis, always flawless. Thank you all so much. Really, we appreciate you all as well. Thank you so much.
I believe we'll be taking a 10-minute break. There's some food and refreshments that will give us an opportunity to hopefully the students stay around so we can take a picture with the students and also thank each and every individual that was here on a personal level. And also students, and I would like to just give you some advice. You know, always listen to your teachers and your parents. Earlier, my former teacher's here. I'm 38 years old and I'm still listening to her. Ms. Garcia advised me that I didn't say hi to her properly, so that's one of the things I gotta go do. I need to go say hi to her again. So if we can have the students come up so we can take a picture. Back to order. Item two, consider and take possible action on travel request from Gria Middle School. Okay. Do you have a motion item two?
I move to approve.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Mr. Ramirez. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign, motion carries. Item three, consider and take possible action on acceptance of the annual financial audit for the year ending August 31st, 2016.
The Education Agency, Mr. Board President, members of the board, Mr. Garcia, the Texas Education Agency requires that an annual financial audit to be conducted by an independent auditor. Noel Garza, CPA, has conducted the audit and presented at the board workshop. with the results of the audit. We, as the administration, recommend approval of the annual financial audit.
Do we have any discussion? Do we have a motion, item three?
So moved.
We have a motion by Dr. Cantu. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Ms. Solis. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item four, consider and take possible action on donations to RGCCISD.
The following donations have been received by RGCCISD, sir. As you can see the list, if you would like me to go in detail by one.
Yes, if you can read them, I believe there's probably a record number of
yes,
donations
sir.
This month.
Yes, sir, will do. RGCCISD Gruya High School for $300 on 11/11/16 from San Isidro ISD. RGCCISD Gruya High School for $200 at 12/1/2016 by Pediatric Practice Association. RGCCISD Gruya High School, $300 on the 1st of December by Salvador Hernandez Jr. RGCCISD Gruya High School for $50 on the 1st of December by Angelitos Healthcare. Rio High School Girls Soccer, $50 on 12/6 by Cheer Design. Rio High School Band, $100 on 12/6/16 by John B. and Rebecca Ramirez. Ringo Elementary, Dr. Ramirez Elementary, and Jose Elementary. Toys valued at $5 each on 12/13/2016 by the Stark County Teachers Federal Credit Union. Rio High School Girls Soccer, $100 on the 13th by Salud Healthcare Services. Rio High School Mariachi Cascabel, $250 on the 13th by Walmart. John and Olive Hinojosa Elementary, Girls Pre-K and K on the 15th of December by RGC High School Migrant Club. John and Hinojosa Elementary, Gifts Entire School by an anonymous donor. John and Olive Hinojosa, Gifts Pre-K, K, and First on the 16th by United States Border Patrol. Roque Guerra Elementary, jackets valued at $3,059 and 15 cents on the 1st of the 10th of January 2017 by J&F Communication Construction. And finally, Rio Grande City CISD for the amount of $100,000 on the first on January the 10th, 2017 by the Wyatt Foundation. Wow, that's a huge one. The administration recommends approval.
I guess just for information, the $100,000 we as a board have not decided what to use it on. We did have instructions from the donor on what he would like to see us use the money. And basically he wants us to make sure it goes to the students in some form or fashion. So if anybody has ideas, relay them to our superintendent and we'll take them into consideration as well.
Congratulations to the board. That's one of a kind. It's, I guess, history in the making. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Item five, consider and take possible action on tax refunds for the month of December 2016.
Presented is a request for approval of the tax refunds for December 2016. Refunds totaling in $4,308.99 being requested. Attached to the summary of the refunds, the administration recommends the approval of the refunds in the amount of $4,309.99.
We have a motion, item five.
So moved.
We have a motion by Dr. Cantu. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Dr. B. Do we, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign, motion carries. Did I do that? Sorry, I'm four.
Huh? Which one?
Did we make a motion, item four? No, we didn't.
No.
sorry. We can go back to item four. Do we have a motion, item four?
So moved.
We have a motion on item four by Dr. Cantu. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Ms. Solis. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign, motion carries. Item six, consider and take possible action on requisition 5,000 over in a 12-month aggregate.
Thank you, Mr. President, members of the board, Mr. Garcia, and ladies and gentlemen. board, we do have requisitions for your consideration on pages 56 through 58. there is a proper funding available for all of these purchases. I don't know if you have any questions on any of them.
Any questions, item six? We have a motion, item six?
So move.
We have a motion by Dr. Cantu. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Mr. Ramirez. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign, motion carries. Item seven, considering take possible action on the interlocal purchasing system TIPS with region, what is that, eight? Education Service Center, Pittsburgh, Pittsburgh, Texas.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. President, members of the board. We are coming to you asking to join the TIPS purchasing cooperative, which is through Region 8. If we're members of, you know, obviously we're members of Region 1, but we've joined, I believe it was Region 13 last school year, which was Texabay, and this is another purchasing cooperative that the district would like to enter into an interlocal agreement with. There's certain companies that the district wants to purchase from, and they're members of this particular cooperative. In fact, there's one for district. It's for a filtering system that the district wants to get for the internet, and they're members of this particular cooperative.
Do we have any discussion, item seven? Do we have a motion, item seven?
I so move to approve the item as presented.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Dr. B. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign, motion carries. Item eight, consider and take possible action on awarding of the following bids. Number 17-10, commercial carpet. Number 17-11, vinyl tile. Number 17-12, concrete. Number 17-13, plumbing. Number 17-14, electrical supplies. Number 17-15, janitorial supplies. Number 17-16, construction materials. Number 17-17, utility work and repairs. Number 17-18, electrical work and repairs. Number 17-19, air condition, HVAC work and repair.
Okay, thank you, Mr. President. Bid number 17-10 through 17-16, these are six-month bids that are effective February 1st and expires on August the 1st. Bid number 17-17 is for a one-year period utility work and repair. Recommendation is to approve those. Bid number 17-18 and 17-19, our recommendation is to reject those two bids and bid them out again.
Any discussion, item eight? Do we have a motion, item eight?
So move.
We have a motion by Mr. Ramirez. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Ms. Solis. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All opposed, same sign, motion carries. Item nine, consider and take possible action on lease purchase agreement.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Smelly.
The technology department with Mr. Sainz and Mr. Gonzalez are asking for permission to sell approximately 1,000 Apple iPod iTouches to a third party vendor instead of sending them to auction. Money obtained from the sale of these iTouches will be used for payment of the portion of the computer lease purchases for the department. The administration recommends approval.
Do we have any discussion, item nine? Do we have a motion, item nine?
I so move.
We have a motion by Dr. Cantu. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Dr. B. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign, motion carries. Item 10, consider and take possible action on request to host the RGCCISD second annual health wellness 5K run.
Mr. President, members of the board, Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Garcia, on item 10, respectfully ask for approval to host our second annual 5K run walk here at Joao R. Sanchez Stadium. Last year, I could say it was a great success. We did have even students from other districts come by. In your packet, you see the letter that goes out to the community. You see the sponsorships and, of course, the divisions, how they're broken up several divisions by age, several awards for each age division. All the proceeds do go back to our kids and as scholarships, los nuestros. Administration recommends approval.
Any discussion on item 10?
I move to approve this item as presented.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Dr. B. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carried.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Solis. Item 11, consider and take possible action on Agile Mind Agreement.
Good evening, Mr. President, members of the board, Mr. Garcia, ladies and gentlemen. The middle school principals and the curriculum department comes before you as presented in the curriculum meeting to go ahead and have 2 days of STAT development with Agile Mind for the middle school math teachers and 2 days of advisory sessions. We do have funding, and it is coming out of Fund 255 from the Teacher Principal Training Grant, and it's for the total cost of $11,000. We recommend approval.
Any discussion, item 11? Do we have a motion, item 11?
I move to approve the item as presented.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Mr. Ramirez. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item 12, consider and take possible action on request for permission to purchase Lenovo notebooks, computers, and charging carts from First Service Technology. Lenovo.
Yes, sir. The middle school principals and curriculum department request permission to go ahead and purchase these notebooks. And there are 25 notebooks per middle school for the four middle schools and a charging cart as well, one per campus for the four middle schools. And this is critical for students and teachers to have necessary supplies to successfully implement the TEKS objectives. The total cost for the 25 notebooks per campus is $27,400. And for the charging carts, it's a total of $7,095. And we do have funding for this, sir. It is coming from the low-income grant, which is Fund 270. We respectfully ask for your approval.
Do we have a motion, item 12?
I so move.
We have a motion by Mr. Ramirez. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Ms. Solis. All in favor say aye.
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 All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item 13, consider and take possible action on amendment of the 2016-2017 tutorial component, Math Matters.
Good evening, Board President, members of the board, Mr. Garcia. As discussed in committee, we are asking for approval for the tutorial component. This is specifically for all migrant students. It will be funded from the migrant program grant 212.
Do you have any questions, item 13? Do we have a motion, item 13?
So move, Mr. President.
We have a motion by Mr. Ramirez. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Mr. Velasquez. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item 14, consider and take possible action on proposed 2016-2017 tutorial component for elementary and middle schools.
Board President, members of the board, this is the second component. This is the elementary and middle schools beginning their tutorial program. This is going to be paid by Title I, 211 and SCE 199. This was discussed in committee as well.
Do we have any discussion, item 14? We have a motion, item 14.
So move.
We have a motion by Mr. Ramirez. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Ms. Solis. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item 15, consider and take possible action on RGCCISD Social Studies STAR Test Migrant Student Program for 8th Grade Implementation Plan, Spring 2017.
Members of the board, I'm asking for approval for this. This is a specific migrant-focused program. And before you make a decision, I do want to share, if you would grant me this opportunity, to share a video about the College First program that's been very successful last year. We're implementing it this year with the elementaries. And I do have the owner and founder of the program, Mr. Ernesto Villarreal. If you would please stand. If you have any questions afterwards, please feel free. So can we play the video?
We did science, we did a rocket ship, we learned about Mars, we learned if we could live there. It was an amazing experience. Like, my mind was blown in the few minutes. Like,
well, today's camp was amazing because we built like rocket ships and we learned a lot about going to Mars, and I liked that a lot. Today's camp was amazing. We got to launch rockets into the sky. And overall, it was a great day full of excitement.
Today was so awesome because we got to learn about Mars and technology. And that makes me very excited for the future.
When I grow up, I want to go to college. And I want to have the best future ever.
I want to reach the stars and conquer my dreams and be the best of the best.
I want to go to college because I want to be happy in my life. I want to be successful. I want to go as far as I can.
It was awesome because like they opened up like a better future for me.
When I get older, I want to make something for this world to make it magical, make an evolution for the future. Migrant program for guiding me to a better future.
Thank you, Migrant Program, for opening those doors of opportunity for me.
For helping me reach my dreams.
Any discussions or questions, item 16?
If I may, Mr. President, I would just say that in curriculum committee meeting, you went into great detail about the plan, and it seems like it's a lot of detailed work. So let me commend you and the entire curriculum department, to be honest. Just seems like what's been asked of you by TA, it seems like it's exhaustive, and it seems to change rather quickly. So what I heard from the curriculum, and I want to thank Mr. Velasquez for joining me that night. And I think you all agree with me that we see it, we recognize the amount of work that you put into it, and from all of us, we thank you for that.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Do we have a motion on item 16?
So moved.
We have a motion by Mr. Ramirez. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Mr. Velasquez. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Martinez. Item 17, consider and take possible action on Pearson Power School renewal.
As presented in the curriculum meeting, sir, we are coming before you to request a renewal license for the management service, and it's for Pearson. We have the total cost is $12,025, and the fund is $199. We ask for your approval.
I so move, Mr. President.
We have a motion by Mr. Ramirez. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Ms. Solis. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Pena. Anything on reports and information?
Thank you, sir. Item one on reports, we just want to update the board and the community on initiative that was approved on November 12th, board's meeting, 2015. And this is a possible action on RGCCISD participation in the HPV vaccine education campaign. And here with us tonight to formally introduce you to the board and to the community, we have Dr. Ana Rodriguez and Iris Tijerina here with us from UTMB and MD Anderson. In your pass out, you do see the PowerPoint that was presented to Insurance Committee, Dr. B, and we feel it's a great opportunity for our district. As you see, it's broken up into several phases. The first phase is a data collection phase, which I believe is due pretty soon, so we need to get this thing going. It was approved, like I said, in November 12th, but just if you had any questions to our board members, Dr. Rodriguez is here tonight.
Good evening, members of the board. Thank you very much for having us and for the opportunity to present our project that is funded by the state. This project aims to increase the HPV vaccination awareness and education among parents. so they can make an informed decision about vaccinating their kids. So our goal is to mainly present the information related to the disease, all the secondary effects, and the advantage of vaccinating their kids. So the first step is to collect the baseline data. We need to find out exactly how many kids in the district are in need of the vaccination. So I'd be happy to take any questions.
I think it needs to be emphasized that it seems like it's more prevalent along the border. And that's something that's...
Yes, one of the reasons why the state funded this proposal is because the HPV diseases are more prevalent and affect more this area of the country. Actually, this is the second spot in the country in terms of cervical cancer rates and other HPV diseases.
And the numbers are saying are 30% higher than
yes. any person. It is 30% higher, the cervical cancer rate in this area when we compare with other areas in the country.
I would just like to say that when you say cancer vaccine, that's pretty significant, and I am just very proud that we've been selected to participate, so thank you very much.
I appreciate the opportunity.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anything else on reports?
That's it.
Oh.
Board President, members of the board, Mr. Garcia, audience. I'd like to present a little bit on the accountability for 2018 that's coming. I know you all have heard a lot of information. Oh, I didn't introduce myself for those of you that are new to the board. My name is Elsa Villarreal, and I'm the director for testing and accountability. And as soon as the ratings came in, I had a visit from Mr. Garcia. He's like, what are all these ratings about? What are all these A through Fs about? Can you explain? So I basically sat down with him and gave him a quick 101 lesson in what the ratings were. The ratings don't have any bearing, so I want to stress that. The ratings were just a hypothetical situation that if we were in the 2018 accountability year, this is how we would fare based on our data from the spring of 2016. So by no means did our accountability rating change for 2016, and I wanted to be clear about that and be clear that everybody understood that our rating for 2016 stands. This was just to give us an idea of where we are and where we need to get and what things that we need to put in place so that we don't end up in a situation with the ratings that we did receive. In your folder, you have a table that has some data, and it's a lot of data based on, like I said, 2016. This is not the data that will be used in 2018, but that's what they used so that they could give us a scenario of where we would be at. But there is a table in there. It's a one-page table, and I'd like to refer to it. It says December 30th, 2015, 2016 ratings, and that's probably the one that came out in the media, came out in the newspaper, was plastered all over Facebook, because I know that Idea Academy said, well, we got A's and B's, and they were bragging about their grades. So I want to point to that table, and this is basically a summary of our district, how our district fared. And if you look at the different domains, and the domains are explained, I'm not going to go through that because I know you all have another meeting after this, but there's four domains in the actual accountability system, the way they're looking at it for 2018. There will be five domains. Nothing is final. As a matter of fact, the committee just met last week, and they're still making changes. So I just want to reiterate that this is just what it may look like, and there's still a lot of changes. Hopefully by April, I'll come back and give you hopefully a final, but we don't know how that is all going to be played out. But I do want to share with you that we do have an issue in domain four. If you look at domain four, that's where we had a lot of F's, and that's probably what everybody was saying. Oh, they had a domain where a lot of people got F's. Those F's came from mainly the elementaries, and the thing I have to explain to you, in the elementary, they're only looking at one component, and they're looking at something called chronic absenteeism. That is very different than the absentee rate. It's not the same thing as attendance rate, and a lot of principals and administrators were thinking, well, I have a 98% attendance. How did I end up with an F? Well, they're not looking at your attendance rate. They're looking at those kids that are chronically absent, meaning that they miss 10 days a semester. So the unique thing about elementary is that if you have usually one brother or sister absent, you're going to have the whole family absent if they're in grades pre-K through through fifth grade. So, you know, you have one child absent, you might have five. So if it's a family of chronic absentee kids, then those are going to affect your rating for that particular domain. One of the suggestions that we made as a valley, as Region 1 to the state, was that for elementary, they could consider some other component besides attendance or besides that chronic absenteeism. Because if you look at I provided you a guide that says A through F overview. And I just want to share how the composite, and this will be the last and I'll be done. It looks like this. And this kind of gives you a summary of how the whole system's going to play out. But I do want to point out where it says current work in progress model. We are going to be receiving a letter grade, an overall letter grade, which is a composite letter grade based on House Bill 2804. And in that composite grade, you see how you have domain one, domain two. They will look at those two domains and they will take the best of one and two, and that will count 35% of the overall grade. For domain three, they will count 20% of the overall grade. And if you look at our domain three for our district, we did very well there. And the reason we did very well in domain three is because it heavily focuses on the economically disadvantaged children and how they did. So we have a fairly good passing rate, and our economically disadvantaged children are passing, then we'll continue to do well in domain three. In domain four, if you look at that, and that was a concern for us, that is worth 35% of the grade. So if you have a campus or you have a school that gets A's in domain one or two and then gets an A in domain three, but in domain four they get an F, then that's going to mess up their whole composite rating, because the last domain, domain five, which wasn't rated in this particular scenario, only counts 10%. And domain five will be something that will be self-graded. That means that our district will come up with that 10%. So even if we receive all the 10%, but we don't do well or don't fare well in domain four, the whole composite grade could be skewed because of that. So one of the things that we did talk to the principals, they've already been trained on the way it's going to look, is that the good thing about receiving our rating, yes, it wasn't where we wanted to be and it's not where we want to be, but the good thing is that we have a heads up. We have the rest of the semester to look at these children who are chronically absent and try to fix it and address those families, because what I told them, if you start looking at the children, you're probably going to see a pattern. It's the same kids that were probably chronically absent the year before and the year before that, and they're probably related to each other. So we can start working on those children and hopefully not have such a poor attendance rate the second semester. So that'll help us at least get ahead of the ball game in that particular domain. So that's kind of like a brief scenario. I gave you all the literature there, and there are some caveats, some things that they suggest that, you know, that we need to be cautious about, that not to assume that this is already set in stone, that this is the way it's going to be. But when it does come out again in April, I will come back and visit with you all and tell you, look, this is the way the accountability is going to look. This is what they're going to be looking at. But let me just say, for 2017, meaning this spring, we're still on the old system. We're still going to receive the same accountability system that we had before based on indexes. This doesn't take effect until the spring of 2018. Does anyone in the board have any questions? I know I speak pretty quick, but I'm just trying to get the information out to you all. Any questions, Mr. Garcia?
No, I think we're good right now. You know, thank you very much for the information, ma'am.
And I'll keep you all informed. I try to turn the information around. As soon as I get it, I try to bring it out to my administrators and to Mr. Garcia, of course. And then one of the things he said is I want my board to, because you all hear things out there, and I just wanted it to be clear that our rating stands. It doesn't affect us. It's just giving us a, hey, heads up. This is how you would do if we were in 2018. So if there are no questions, I am done. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
Thank you. I will make sure that every information that goes out to the principal will come to you all also, so that you can be kept abreast in reference to how we're going to be rated.
Anything else on reports? No. It is 8:05. We'll be heading to closed session under authority of the Texas Government Code Section 551.071. It is now 9:28. We're out of executive session. Do we have a motion on item A? No action? No, there's no action item A. Do we have a motion item B?
I move that we approve this item as presented in executive session.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis. Do we have a second?
Second. Second.
We have a second by Mr. Ramirez. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Do we have a motion on item C?
I move that we approve this item as discussed in executive session.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis on item C. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Dr. B. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Do we have a motion on item D?
I recommend that we approve this item as presented in executive session.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Mr. Velasquez. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Do we have a motion on item E?
I move that we approve this item as presented in executive session.
We have a motion on item E. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Mr. Ramirez. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item F, do we have a motion on item F?
I move that we approve this item as discussed in executive session.
We have a motion on item F. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Dr. B. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item G, do we have a motion on item G?
I move that we approve this item as presented in executive session.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis on item G. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Mr. Velasquez. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item H, do we have a motion on item H?
I move that we approve this item as presented in executive session.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Mr. Velasquez. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Or Dr. Cantu, sorry. A second by Dr. Cantu. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item I, do we have a motion item I?
I move that we approve this item as presented in executive session.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Dr. B. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. We have a motion item J.
Can we have some clarification from council? On?
Yeah, so there's three options. Grant, deny, grant in part, and deny in part, or no action.
Okay. Oh, I see. Okay. I move, as far as item J, I would move to deny.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis on item J. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Dr. Cantu. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item K, do we have a motion item K?
I move that we approve this item as presented in executive session.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Dr. B. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. Item L. Do we have a motion item L?
I guess on item L, we would move to table it. We have two options that we kind of were working with that we'd like Mr. Garcia to get some more information back to us on the bid. I'm sorry. It was on the check. This is something else. My bad. I move to approve the item as presented in executive session.
We have a motion by Ms. Solis on item L. Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a second by Mr. Ramirez. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed, same sign. Motion carries. We have a motion for adjournment.
So moved.
We have a motion by Mr. Ramirez. Do we have a second?
Second.
Second. It's 9:32. Meeting is now adjourned.